weighed when he had an MMA fight. Will that weight make any difference to him? We're going to find out. He's facing a height and reach disadvantage. He needs to get on the inside.
Once again, let me welcome you to the fabulous Mercedes-Benz Stadium here in ATL, Atlanta, Georgia, USA, where tonight Triller Fight Club is proud to present the main event of the evening, 8 rounds of boxing in the cruiserweight division. And this is sanctioned by the Georgia State Athletic Commission and sponsored by DraftKings. Commission Executive Director Matt Woodruff. At ringside, the three judges scoring: Ed Kanner, Nola Oliver, and Richard Sells. And inside the ring, in charge of the action at the bell, your referee, Brian Stutz. And now, the officials are in place and they are ready. The fighters are in the ring and they are ready. So from Mercedes-Benz Stadium, Atlanta, Georgia, to the millions watching around the world, let's get ready to rumble!
That's what I'm here for. Okay.
What Jake Paul did predict before two rounds are done, he's going to put away Ben Askren.
Being out there fighting like a 1940s fighter with that old ass style.
Yeah.
He's going to change that style. Look, that's that.
Jake Paul being a lot more disciplined than I thought.
Yeah, that's the style the fighters used to use in the 1930s. He's going to change that shit up.
Oh, there's a left hook on the top of the head by Paul.
Bang.
Shit.
Shot to the body.
Body shot to them ribs. Bang. Right to the motherfucking head.
He's a fucking bad boy, dude.
He is. Jake, get out. I tried to tell you.
Jake's a bad boy.
You think I'm going to put $2 million on the motherfucking goofball? What the fuck?
Shit. Jake Paul sparred with former world champion Jean Pascal.
Get my money, Jake. Get my motherfucking money, Jake. Get my motherfucking money.
Said the referee, Brian Stutz, what I'm ready. Brian Stutz said, you were stumbling, son. You saw that Ben Askren took the mandatory 8 count. That's then in the hands of referee Brian Stutz. He felt that Ben Askren was not able to continue. Askren pleaded his case, but to no avail. And that's the game set match, Jake Paul.
He was singing one of them bedtime stories, like, rock-a-bye, baby, on the treetop. Jake hit his motherfucking ass $2 million off top.
Marty, quick stoppage, yes or no?
Dana White, it could be debated that was a quick stoppage. I think he should have been given the benefit of the doubt, to be honest with you. Jake Paul had just won Mike Bottom with a hard right, but I'd like to see him continue and get that chance.
All right, so
you been too.
Mario Lopez says he thinks it was a quick stoppage. What do you think?
I personally think he could have let it go a little bit longer.
A little bit.
Given him a chance.